produce food.
Headingley, in the past 40 years of Ashes battles, has been a wonderful ground for England. They've won 6 matches to Australia's 2.
He caught him! A great catch by Illingworth.
Well, it's swung away, that surely it. Straight away is a long leg for 4 runs. It's all over. That's it. That's a half volley through mid-arm for 4. 100 the place to get it. A little of a test match against Australia on his home ground at Headingley.
Sickly away for 4. That's a split at 100. A great innings by Ian Botham. Bowled him. It's all over. And it is one of the most fantastic victories ever known in test cricket history. Between the fielder at cover point and extra cover, and Tim Robinson brings up his 150.
Happy memories of this ground for England over the years. I can tell you that the pitch for today's game had about it a whitish look. Didn't stop Alan Border deciding to bat when he won the toss from Graham Gooch. A big decision.
Well, it looks a very good wicket to me, and with the weather conditions the way they are, hopefully it plays pretty well the way it looks, and we can get some runs on the board and play the match from there.
What about your team selection? Trouble with the seamers, I believe.
Yeah, well, they haven't really been bowling fantastically well, and Brendan Julian pulled a groin muscle on the nets yesterday, so we really didn't have too many choices. But we just think that our best bowling attack is the one we've gone in with the 2 spinners and a couple of seamers. And a little bit of backup bowling from the wars, etc. So hopefully that proves correct.
Yeah. Graham, a lot of speculation about Headingley, always. The same again, I think.
Yeah, you never know. As Alan says, the overhead conditions play a bit of a part here. We've lost the toss, so we'll be bowling. I'd have batted if I'd have won the toss. It looks a good surface, but, you know, it's one of those grounds that's very unpredictable. And it can play well for a while, and then suddenly it can start jagging around everywhere. So you just never know here.
Yeah, we talk more about seam than spin, don't we?
Well, England have played seamers here over the years, and they've historically bowled sides out. Some would say that's because we've never had a spinner in the side, but you know, history tells you that the seamers get the wickets here, and we're hoping that's going to be the same this year.
Confirmation there of the 2 teams announced by the captains. England have gone in without Peter Such. They have the 4 seam bowlers. The Australians have gone the other way with Shane Warne and Tim May. Paul Rifle is in the side in place of the injured Brendan Julian. And the 2 umpires, Harold Bird and Nigel Plews. And just to confirm again, Australia won the toss and will bat. The 2 openers, Mark Taylor and Michael Slater. And bowling the first ball of this 4th test match now, we have Martin McKay. And 4 to start. Certainly not off the middle of the bat, but it didn't go in the air. Arlett took a tumble and the ball went through head high to Alex Stewart.
Well, it was a beauty from Mark Arlett. He pitched it up. Mark Taylor never really got forward. No real feet movement there.
Well,
well, that's a very interesting over. One ball through chin height, another one bouncing twice through to Alex Stewart. Or more to Mark Taylor. Once again, like the first boundary of the day from the first ball, that didn't actually come off the full face of the bat. Once again, off the thick edge. Very difficult to cut off a ball that beats the field here at Headingley when it's running down towards this football ground end. That's quite a good stroke from Mark Taylor. I'm not certain that he got it off the middle of the bat. The fielder will collect it and they'll get only three. But not quite a time that she would have wished. That's nicely timed by Slater. I just got a feeling, Jeff, the outfield's a bit slow today. Seems a bit slower than some other games we've seen up here.
Yes, well, they have had quite a bit of rain a few days ago. And you find most places, the golf courses are quite slow.
Andrew Caddick has bowled his first ball of this fourth test match, a full toss, and it went the same way as McCaig's first ball, down to third man. It took Slater by surprise as well.
Beautiful line and length. This is what he bowled so well at Nottingham when England were trying to defeat Australia.
Oh, wasn't a true half volley, but what a flourish.
Slater really does like to get on that front foot. Anything up at all, and he really flashes at it.
Now comes a problem for Gooch, because Eilert must be coming near the end of his spell. He wants to bowl Bicknell, but by choice, Bicknell wouldn't want this end. This four more, but that really was hard luck on Eilert. He did everything right, and the luck went with the batsman.
Yes, and things look a bit ominous at the moment for England. Runs just begin to flow off the bat. Wide signal there by umpire Dickie Bird. I must admit, Martin McCaig doesn't look to be hitting his run upright at the moment to me. There's a lot of small stuttering steps and doesn't seem just right as he's coming in at the moment to me.
McCaig at the moment, well, he's in trouble with his run up. 50 up.
Somewhere near right there. It's still a little wide, and well, Slater were a little bit annoyed at playing defensively at that. That was too wide to play defensively at, but the length was good.
just gets there, that's four runs. And so often you see it when there's a man short on the offside in front, the bowler somehow subconsciously just slants the ball occasionally towards middle and leg, and that's meat and drink with just two fielders on the onside. That's in the air. Very high element of risk in that stroke by Slater, tested by McCaig with a short ball.
Yes, and Michael Slater knows it was a false shot. He got to the other end. When that ball was in the air, I bet his heart was in his mouth. It was an edge, a top edge. It went up high. Unfortunately for Australia, it fell safely.
Long half volley. Beautifully played.
Another very, very good innings from Michael Slater. So far in this series, he's made 58, 27, 152, 40, 26, and now another half century. And it was time for a big shout. Been very little joy there for the bowlers this morning. Occasionally they've gone past the outside edge, but it's not that time.
Just judging by Mark Taylor's reaction there, there may have been an inside edge.
LBW. Bicknell has his first wicket and the partnership is broken. Long time to wait for Mark Taylor, with umpire Clues trying to work out, had the ball pitched in line with the stumps, which it has to do, the right-arm bowler coming over the wicket. 27 for Mark Taylor, and the first breakthrough for England.
Good bowling there from Martin Bicknell to get his first victim in Test cricket. Pitching right on line and just straightening a little bit. It hit the bat, but it had bounced off the pad before it went on to the bat. Bicknell emphatic in his shout. Clues took quite a long time, but then the former policeman sent Mark Taylor on his way.
And that's a great breakthrough. David Boone is the new batsman for Australia. Shot. That's as good a stroke as we've seen this morning.
You can't afford to make a mistake when you're bowling to Michael Slater, because he'll punish you. The England bowlers have made quite a few mistakes this morning, and they've been punished regularly.
Wonderful cover drive in the early part of the over, and very, very good hook there. That's a nice start for Boone, particularly after two or three rather tentative jabs. Been given one right in the slot. And he's got that away beautifully again. Just
seems to me he's playing that stroke a little differently today, making certain that he's not playing it outside his body, getting his body right in line with the ball, so that if he does happen to miss it, not just pushing away at the chance of offering a catch to the keeper. Last ball before lunch. Might have tried it earlier.
Beautiful delivery there from Mark Eilert to finish proceedings in the pre-lunch session. 103 for one. Wonderful knock from young Michael Slater. 64 and unbeaten. And with him, David Boone on five. Mark Taylor, 27. But a great session to start this fourth test match for the Australians. Not so for those bowlers there. Four of them, all seam bowlers. McCaig, none for 43. Eilert, none for 25. Caddick, none for 10. And Bicknell, one for 21. We join play now after lunch. It's the fourth over. Seven runs have been added. Mark Eilert is the bowler. Michael Slater is taking strike.
Now that was a good bouncer in that it did induce a false stroke.
Well, he just aborted the stroke, you might say, at the last moment, but he was committed and he's trying to abort it, but I would have said that was a victory for the bowler, that he really did play the shot and only tried to abort it after he'd gone through.
Oh, through. He's walking and head down at the end of a great innings. It really was a super bit of bowling as well. The bouncer and then the full Yorker. Classic 1-2. An end of a fine innings from Michael Slater. Goal by Eilert for 67, and Australia now 110 for 2.
Well, I think it was really good bowling by Mark Eilert. Set him up with a bouncer, but he hits across it, does Michael Slater. You see the ball going straight on, it's sort of half volley, it's not really up with a Yorker. And Michael Slater will be cross with himself, that hit off stump. He would have felt that he should have played a little bit straighter and not around to mid-wicket, but batsmen don't make mistakes, they don't get out.
New batsman Mark Waugh, and that's a good start for this middle session of the day for England. Oh, man in the right position, that was a catch. Round about the fourth slip area, where there's nobody at all. End of the over, could have been better for England even than 112 for two.
Cracking stroke from David Boone, beautifully played off his pads.
That one and the previous one, as good as anything we've seen here on this ground today. That's Wilfilla Bialik. Chopped down what would have been four, just to the single. Contempt is too strong a word, but Boone did give that a tremendous bit of hammer.
watching Mark Islett and Bicknell bowl at the moment. I would suggest that if anything, they are a yard short of the length they ought to be bowling. And the ball chance to swing.
He plays that square cut pretty well.
It's much too short. Too short again. Experience tells me that it's not easy to pitch the ball exactly where you want it all the time, but if you get a pitch of this kind, I say keep it simple.
It's a great shot again. It's that little short arm jab. I don't know precisely what the replay will show, but the one where he hit the ball previously through mid on, he had no follow through at all timing. Bicknell couldn't make it, didn't pick it up until late, and it was very much a sliced stroke from David Boone. Bicknell didn't get his eyes on it. Stewart started to run back.
Well, Heading has never been the easiest of grounds for picking the ball up. Looking at that popular side, quite a bank of spectators, different colours. You've many times seen players go the wrong way, and I think there was just that slight hesitation when he first started. And you see, it's only a matter of a couple of paces.
It's not the place to bowl to David Boone. He doesn't miss too many of those. It was a pretty good stroke. I suppose you could say he might have been fired up by almost picking up a wicket in the last over when he had Boone miscueing on the short pitcher.
Oh, it's danger. If he hits, he's out. The second throw hit, but he was not out. Well, it's very unlike these two experienced Australian batsmen, but just watch this. It's the dummy sold there by David Boone. Well, he was going. Then came the no, then the throw, and it was all over for Mark Waugh. And that was close. Ah, great shot. Just that little bit on the up, as David Boone often plays that cover drive. And levered it through the covers. Four runs.
The Australian batsmen today have really pounced on anything that is a little bit wide. Michael Slater set the pattern early. David Boone following his example.
Cracking shot, and that beats third man. It's 20 yards to his right. It's a beautiful stroke, plenty of power in it.
Once again, a bit of width there for Mark Waugh. He is a very, very strong onside player, but plays the square cut extremely well.
That's beautifully played again, and that's his 50. There's a fielder close in front, but there's a mid-off behind, but David Boone recognised an orthodox off-drive when he saw one and really weighed into it. An excellent half century.
before more.
There's 27 boundaries this today altogether, so that's 108 out of 193, and well, that's just unacceptable at test level. Width and four. It's almost one and over now. Wonderful fielding. Well, Nasser Hussain has always been a magnificent fielder, but you'll see nothing better than this. That's the 200. And this is the 54th over. The 100 came up in the 26th. That was effortless.
This from Martin McCaig is just running down the leg side. And the batsman can use the pace of the ball. Just a little flick and it zoomed off the back like lightning down to fine leg.
One more run was added to take the score along to 209 for two at tee. Slater 67, Taylor 27, the men out. And Boone on 57 and Mark Waugh 45. The bowling figures for England, nothing very impressive there. Islet a wicket and one for Bicknell. We join play after tea. It's the second ball. No runs have been added. Caddick is the bowler, and Mark Waugh is taking strike.
That's very well run. Mark Islet, the fielder. Straight between the man at forward square and the man at mid-on. Well, always races away down to that corner, but it is a bit slow today. And the partnership between Mark Waugh and David Boone.
Oh! Well, he has found some very strange ways to get out in this series, not least playing no stroke to one that looked as though it might have swung in very late. Bowled by Islet. Desperate need for a breakthrough from England, and Mark Islet has achieved it.
Well, it didn't really do that much. I think it was more a misunderstanding by Mark Waugh. It pitched on an eight, and he'd be disappointed with that. Playing so well, and really, there's nothing in that delivery that he couldn't have played. It's, he'll be disappointed with that dismissal.
Alan Border is the new batsman, so that is the break so badly needed by England. Every so often one does something like that.
This is one of the reasons why you're never actually in at Headingley. Now that really did go. Went like a leg break, bounced, did everything. Oh. Sort of thing that builds your confidence up as a batsman.
Big shot there from Caddick, and every England player behind Alan Border.
Caddick was quite adamant there, but I think all pitching outside leg stump.
Great shot. Don't catch that down the hill here, Headingley, towards the rugby stand. Beautifully middled by David Boone.
Yes, no excessive follow through, just a short punch. Right hand just coming in and bang, four runs. Doesn't miss many of those, David Boone.
Oh, that's a marvellous shot. Absolutely regal stroke there from David Boone. On the up, wide of the off stump.
No one moved.
Oh, beautifully bowled. If that sort of thing can happen, it makes you wonder why it hasn't happened more often during the day.
Well, this is one of those deliveries which Headingley is famous for. Just did a little bit off the seam. It didn't do as much as it looked, actually. It did more after the batsman had played and when it had gone past the bat.
Oh, and one the other way.
Now, that was a magic ball. That would get most people out. Beautifully bowled, pitched, look at that, leg stump, maybe even outside, and past off stump going up. In fact, that ball was too good to get a nick.
Lovely shot
on the up.
Well, that wasn't a bad ball from Andrew Caddick. It was just a superb shot. He took this ball from outside off stump and whacked it through straightish mid-on, slightly on the up, with a straight bat. Just a man in top form, full of confidence.
Pace of the pitch just dictated that stroke. Banged in, and someone of Bicknell's pace can't do that to Boone.
Yes, you can't just bang the ball in on a Headingley pitch. It's a little bit like pudding. The ball sits up and says, whack me.
Oh, wonderfully bowled. And this is Bicknell's best spell of the day, and England's as well.
Yes, Martin Bicknell keeps bowling some really good deliveries. This one pitching, bouncing a little bit. David Boone feeling for it and lobbed up safely.
Pitched it up and got the treatment.
Well, Alan Board has not looked all that safe, but it's been a question of surviving against the good balls and whacking the bad ones.
Four more.
Yes, you just give these Australians a little bit of room. They whack it away so well.
That's very well played by Border. Short boundary and just guided away beautifully.
Yes, Alan Border's played a long time for his runs, but he's beginning to come to terms with the pitch now and make a few fluent shots.
269 for 3, 16 extras there. Very, very good knock from Boone. Beautifully helped around. Boone didn't bother swatting that away, just eased it off the middle of the bat.
Well, this has been England's problem, that they can't keep the ball in the right place for long.
There's a very good shot from Alan Border, but I'd have thought McCaig would have picked up
the lesson by now that this is not actually the pitch on which to bowl short on leg stump.
Yes, Buddha, plenty of time to play the shot, just helping it round to square leg.
Gee, that's well played. Lovely square drive. I'm sure on the replay that'll show a beautifully angled bat just at the moment of impact from Alan Border.
Yes, he got a big heavy bat, Alan Bird. It didn't give it a big swing. Just a matter of opening the face there.
Well, it was there for the taking, 96, and you get a long hop outside off stump, and you're one of the best square cutters the world's ever seen. You're still on 96.
Yes, he'd like to have got it tonight, and I'm sure that he thought, oh, dear me. That was it.
There it is. Doesn't make the same mistake twice in missing a square cut, although McCaig made the same mistake twice in giving him the opportunity. That's another lovely innings from David Boone. Quite outstanding.
Yes, a wonderful knock from David Boone, and five more runs added to take it along to 307 for three at the close. Border is with him on 38. No joy for the England bowlers. I thought Bicknell was the best of them. 21 overs, four maidens and one for 63, but real problems for the four-man seam attack. Here now with their ideas on the day, Ian Chappell and Geoffrey Boycott.
For me, Ian, the most puzzling aspect of the day was the morning's presentation of the teams. Australia played both spinners, and England didn't play any spinner at all.
Yes, I guess when that happens, that by the end of the Test match, one set of selectors is going to be proved wrong. Mm. And I must say that I fancy, as often as possible, that you have a balanced attack, and I think that that's what Australia have got. And having made a good score, now they're set up perfectly to use their two spinners.
Yes, well, knowing Headingley pretty well, I've played most of my cricket here. Seamers, it does help, but I would always want one spinner. And Headingley hasn't very often helped the quicker bowlers. A man like McCaig who bangs the ball in, it sits up on this kind of spongy type of surface. And I was disappointed with England's selection.
And what about all these snakes? What did they slide down the ladders, did they? We didn't see any of these snakes of yours here today.
No, I don't think England bowl well, did they, to be honest. I mean, full credit to Australia. They batted well. Their batting is very simplistic and good. But to be honest, I don't think we bowl well. We didn't put the ball in the right area often enough to get those snakes at Australia. The only man that did a bit was after tea, Martin Bicknell. If they'd have bowled like that all the time, I think England would have done better.
That's a great day for the Australians. And to put it in proper perspective, bear in mind that in 1989, when Australia slaughtered England here at Headingley, the score at the close of play on the opening day was Australia 207 for three. Here today they've made another 100 runs and they've lost no more wickets, so they are in one terrific position. The England bowlers didn't have a good day. It must have been a sad day for Graham Gooch, I would think, but David Boone was absolutely terrific. We'll be on air tomorrow, BBC Two, 10:55 a.m. For the moment, it's goodbye.